God, my head. Ouch. My leg. My leg. I can move it, so I guess it's just a sprain.
And it just looks down and it's just rebar through it.
Where? I'm not at home, am I? It can't be. Oh. It's so dark, I can barely see a thing. So this is the school. Oh, there we go. What's going on? What the hell is this place? Oh, we're in control, okay. There's a loose board lying on the ground, though scratch and bang out seems to be fully intact. Oh, everything, okay. I thought I was gonna about to take it or something. Wait, does she have amnesia now? Cause she's like, where am I? She doesn't think she's in the school anymore? I guess she wants to keep going this way, okay. So yeah, obviously this is a PSP game, so the graphics aren't that great, but it's all about the story, really. And the anime art is not bad either. Psycho. This isn't good. Can she not hear me? Oh, do I have to go back for that board now? Okay, now I can grab the board. Or I cannot. Is there a way around? Okay. All right, now I can go this way. I'm coming, psycho. Oh, shit. That really hurt. My ankle is pretty bad shape. Ooh. Note. Heavenly Post. Third student reported missing. One by one, the young students of Heavenly Host blank school seems to be disappearing as the third students join. Wait, Heavenly Host School was the school before that this school is now on, right? I got that right? Classmate testified that the fifth grader blank was on her way home from school. She got separated from her friends in the hall and hasn't been seen since. Police are investigating possibility of kidnapping, have assigned countless investigators to case hopes be a resolution. However, 10 days have already passed since the first disappearance, giving parents, classmates, ample cause for concern. Why is that there? There's some sort of official looking printout on the wall. Huh? No time for that, yeah. Okay. Sikio. Someone's gonna correct me how to say that. I think it's this psycho. Thank goodness she's still breathing. Psycho, come on. Psycho. Wake up. Ning. Naomi, what's up? Don't you what's up me? I thought you were dead. Where are we? What's going on? That's what I'd like to know. Is her leg also busted? No, it ain't budging. These windows are sealed up tight. And it's pitch black out there. I can't make heads or tails of what I'm seeing. Oh, I'm sorry. I just figured it out. I think the reason why the girl didn't recognize where she was at is probably because this isn't the school. We're in the old school that used to be there. I just realized that. Well, this is clearly a school building. But don't the desks seem usually small to you, though? Like an elementary school. An elementary school? It can't be, can it? Oh shit.
What is it?
The print on the wall. It says Heavenly Host Elementary. Notes to all faculty and students.
Heavenly Host?
Oh my god. How did we get here? What's happening? Where are our friends and Miss Yu? Calm down, Psycho. Don't get so worked up. Snap out of it. Oh shit. Okay, she calmed down. Psycho and I just stood there in silence, hand in hand. It was the first time in my life that I had been shaking so hard I could hear my teeth chatter. I'd become completely lightheaded and I couldn't even think straight, much less wrap my brain around what was happening to us. I kept telling myself, it's all a dream, some horrible nightmare, but no matter how hard I wished for it, I just couldn't wake up. That's brutal. And the silence was the worst part of all. I couldn't take it anymore. I had to say something, anything. Hey, I don't have the slightest idea what's going on, but how about we try finding a way out of here?
A way out? Huh?
We can't just stand here quaking in terror. We need to do something, you know. Besides, I don't want to be in this creepy place any longer than I have to. But the windows are all sealed shut. And I don't just mean that they're stuck or locked. It's like they're decorations on the wall. I don't even think they can open. Is it even possible to leave this building? We'll find a way. I'm not sure if there's... But if there's entryway or emergency exit or something. Some means of getting outside. You're right. It's just a lot better than just standing around. I feel like I'm going to go all loony in here helping this bitch. Alright, then let's go. We've got to keep our spirits up after all. It's probably not just the two of us in here. Why would you say that? Oh, okay. Yeah, if we could just reunite with them. We'll find a way out of here together. I like how the music kicked in as like a way of like motivating you to get out of the room. I had no reason to believe any of what I just said. I was probably delirious, to be honest. But I knew if I didn't act, I'd start to go mad. I'd start to scream. I'd be inconsolable. So in desperation, I put on the strongest front I could manage. Okay. Direct your eye towards the characters and press the X button to learn more about him or her. When you're done, exit through the door in the southeast side of the room to resume play. Okay, well, I do know a little bit of this guy, yeah. Fairly average, but popular, known for being a coward. Despite his timidness, he's very personable. He's very personable and open, which causes Jonas towards. Okay, yeah, he's the leader guy. He's like the main character, basically. That's cool. That's alright. It's fucking lightning. Naomi, 16-year-old, frequently greets Toshi with, "Oh, not you again." Having lost her father a few years back, Naomi and her mother now depend on one another's moral support. She's real optimistic and cheerful. That's good. We need that. Given interest in nursing, she's intent on pursuing. She spends her time studying, aiming for acceptance to medical school. Psycho, 16-year-old, lives close to Naomi, generally can... Okay, so they're like best friends. Free spirit often says or does things that take others by surprise. She isn't so easily forgiven due to the good nature and admirability. Her mother disappeared 3 years ago, leaving her three siblings to work and a working father. Oh, okay, so she's like a strong girl. Okay. And then that's the little sister. I guess I'll look at her bio. Yeah, 8th grade. Yep. She's always been a princess, generally getting her way. Plus, she's kind of like spoiled. Often attempting to act older or braver than she is, sometimes gets her. Oh, okay. That's alright, too. Now, who's this guy? Been in theater club. He's an actor. He finds socializing with anyone else to be more trouble than it's worth. So he's typically regards other classrooms as okay. Takes pride in his family heritage, reacts violently if anyone makes fun of his name. Why would you make fun of his name? Give him the nickname Sheep. Okay. Mayu, 16 years old, somehow looks much thinner than she actually is, but possesses a big heart. Oh, okay. That's why they said that. Accepts everyone and everyone in open arms, never playing favorites. Yeah, and she's also moving. Yeah. All right. But yeah, what a last day, too. 17-year-old, ghost stories. So she's like a prankster. Carries the home goods. Just in case I was okay. Where's her reputation as a mask to hide her own fear of the unknown? Interesting. Faced with a truly scary situation, her knees give out in panic. Wow, so even though she plays tough, she's just really, really cowardly when shit goes down. And this dude, sarcastic and cynical. Yes. Just like Vitna. As far as he's concerned, it's just being honest. Yeah, he'll make an exception now and again if either is involved. For the intense drama at home, he currently works part-time after school to afford rent on a small apartment which he lives alone. Oh, wow. Okay, so he's a very independent young guy. And a 23-year-old English teacher. Wow. Good for you. Not a perfect instructor by any means. Her unjaded zeal enthusiasm with her students are generally responsive to her methods. She seems to have real connections with the students here. Alright, great. Let's move on, though. Come on, Naomi, let's go. Alright. And the music still plays, too. Sick. Wait a sec. What? Oh, shit. Another earthquake? Are you joking? Is it over? I've had enough. Just get out of this room. Wait, was that there before? What's wrong? This hallway looks totally different than it did before. That's crazy. And maybe that is what the earthquake is. It's just... Can I jump over that? There's a gap. Seems crossable, a little too wide. This looked like I could climb down it for some reason, but that's not a vine. That's just some green stuff. There's a yellow fluid. What? The heck is this? Yeah, of course. Go with the first yellow liquid you can think of. If I'm right, I could take this now, right? Hey, Naomi. What? Something wrong with your leg? Yeah, I was so freaked out I forgot all about it. I think I sprained my ankle and fell. Well, that's not good. Will you be okay? She's been fine this whole time, but she's fine. We gotta keep moving forward. They're nice little best friends. Yes. Is it just one, though? Because I saw two... Was that ghost sound? Anyway. Alright, let's see. Is there a pause? Not a pause. I have this. So I'm actually going to make a save state here. Because you can get game overs in this game, as I've been told. There's a gap. Yeah. There's a gap up there and there's a gap down here, so hopefully I can take this loose board with me to explore down there. And it worked! And there's nothing? Wait, no, it was that. Okay, before we explore down there, can I take the board back? I can't. Why can't I? Yeah, there's this too. Ugh. Hold on. Alright. Let's try up here real quick. Yes, we can now use the board. Yeah, oh, I guess. Yeah, I kind of wanted to explore up here. Let's look at the first floor. Spooky classroom. Oh, shit. What is wrong? Look over there. Aren't those bones like people bones? That's pretty brutal. Why is there a dead person here? Wait, let me look at them more closely. Yep, it's a dead person. Maybe they're not real. Yeah, there really are somebody's bones. But why? You two... What? You two are new victims, are you not? No. A ghost. Who are you? I was brought here against my will and confined just like... Or maybe it's the soul of those of that dead body, maybe. We already know where is here, but confined? Confined? You mean there's no way out? I'm afraid not. This school exists in the reality of all known, cut off from the world you know. So why have you been brought here? They brought you. They're consistently bringing new victims to the school more and more all the time. Sinless innocents, one after another. This is a cursed multidimensional nexus. Damn. Created by powerful, vengeful spirits. Closed space, or perhaps closed spaces. We are unlucky victims of an inescapable abduction. Indeed. It seems you two are not the only ones that have been brought here. I'm sensing numerous others. Does that mean everybody else here is too? Are they okay, I wonder? So our friends are inside the school too? I don't know what exact number, but I do know that others are pulled into these spaces at the same time as you. They are definitely in the school. Oh my god, that's such good news. I mean, Mochita's here too. I bet that makes you feel a lot better, right? However, you cannot meet them. They're all definitely in the school, but the space they occupy differs from the space we occupy. Also, there are different realities or something. If you wish to see your friends, you must be able to find some means of entering their space or bringing them into the space. Even then, escape is near impossible, and that at least you'll be able to die together. I don't want that. You said we were brought here by vengeful spirits, right? Who were they? Why have they taken us? I don't know. Neither the motives of our captors nor the means of escaping this hell. All I know is that with some effort, you can get at least live out your days together. Two heads are better than one. Your chances and your opportunities are so much greater than working together. Do whatever you can to find a way out of here. Don't end up like us. Who's that? Okay. What is that? Run, we need to get out of here. What's that on the boards?
Holy shit.
That was real freaky. Are you alright, Psycho? Yeah, but what the hell was that? A child's spirit? It kind of glow. I never believed in ghosts before. Is this really happening? There were definitely ghosts in there. First time I've ever seen something like that. So you saw it too, right? Yeah. We were talking to it. I just don't understand any of this. Except that there's no easy way out for us. Like it or not, we're stuck in here. It'll be okay. Let's just, you know, march on with our heads held high or something. And the music just kicks in. Oh shit. I doubt we can pass. Can we pass? If you should die here, you'll experience the pain you felt at the moment of your death for all eternity. And it's completely cut off. No paradise, no nirvana, just eternal pain. Great, well. Did it just drop an item? I acquired an unknown key. So we'll feel the pain of death forever? Best not to think about that. Oh no! Chairs are in the way! We'll never pass that. Wow. That's crazy. Well, that's not the button I meant to hit. So we can't go in there? I'm guessing we can't go down there. Yeah, so far this is really interesting. Can I get another board? Did they respawn? No, probably not. Yeah, it's funny how, like, the chairs are in the way, so I can't... I know it said rubble, but just it looked like just chairs were just in the way. Alright, I'm gonna have to go back into there. Or can I do anything with this bucket? No, nothing. Wait, do we go in here? Wait a minute. Just want to make sure there's no extra boards. No, no extra boards. But yeah, so far this game looks really, really interesting and fun. Little things like that, it just makes me laugh. I can't help but to laugh. I guess we'll go back in. Maybe it calmed down. Maybe. I love how there's just a candle there. What is that Scissor Man? What the heck is this? Was this here before? I don't know, but it's just a picture, right? Please zoom in on the picture. The image depicts a figure holding a pair of scissors, pursuing small... Oh my god, that's bullshit. What is there always... Is there always a candle? I don't think so, but it does look awfully familiar. And it's the save! Alright. Oh man, I feel like I am going to enjoy this game. I hope you guys will enjoy this series, but for now, I'm on limited time tonight, but I hope you guys will enjoy the Let's Play, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace out.